Hello, this is Jane Goodall, and it's World Swift Day. You know, swifts are among the most incredible of birds. There are very many species, and they are found in almost all parts of the world. And all of them are spectacular in the air. Some of them actually reach a top speed of up to 110 kilometers per hour. And they accompany their flight with acrobatic maneuvers. Swifts can feed and mate in the air. They can even power nap on the wing because they're able to shut down half of their brain while the other half stays alert. All species can fly for months without landing, and some, like the common swift, only touch ground during the nesting season. They make their nest in small holes and can enter while flying at more than 60 kilometers per hour. In America, some species of swifts make nests behind waterfalls. Others glue their nests inside chimneys. All swifts use their saliva to glue nesting material together and to attach their nests to their chosen sites. Some are attached to walls, and in Africa and Asia, some are actually glued to palm fronds. Some species, Australian swiftlets, make nests in underground caves, and they use echolocation like bats. Some swifts, who nest in the northern hemisphere, migrate vast distances to warmer climates for the winter. The European common swift flies up to 22,000 kilometers, and this includes between 2,500 to 3,500 kilometers over the Sahara Desert. The Chinese swift, around 14,000 kilometers from Beijing to Central Africa in the winter, and over 14,000 kilometers back to nest in the spring. Sadly, these fantastic little birds are all threatened by human activities, by our activities. All of them are insectivorous, and industrial farming with its use of pesticides and herbicides has a devastating effect because it's killing the insects on which the swifts feed. Then climate change has caused disruption of weather patterns. There are more violent storms, which can be disastrous when they occur during a swift migration, because they can be blown way off course. Swifts often fly close to the forest canopy or low over wetlands, and these are the places where insects abound, so that deforestation and the draining of wetlands deprive swifts of their insect prey. And in America, mass tourism or irresponsible climbers near waterfalls, where there are swift colonies, the birds can also be harmed, as is the destruction of old chimneys in North America. The common swift in Europe has, for hundreds of years, lived in harmony with humans, nesting in nooks and crannies of our buildings. But now, renovation or insulation of buildings in the fight against climate change means that the swifts are losing more and more of those traditional nesting sites. They arrive in the spring and find their entrance holes blocked up. But there is hope, because an increasing number of swift lovers are dedicated to finding solutions to some of the birds' problems. In Europe, many people, including groups of young people in Jane Goodall Institute's Roots and Shoots program and other volunteers, are making and installing nest boxes, and they're getting increasing support from governments. Other volunteers are lobbying governments and industry to save the swift's environment. And a number of construction companies have been persuaded to incorporate suitable nesting cavities in new buildings. but this urgent need to do more to save some species from extinction. For one thing, it's important to raise awareness. We need more people to understand just how amazing these tiny aviators are. And once you know, then surely you'll be inspired to help. That's why the World Swift Day is so important, because it's a day when we can share information with our friends, and social media can help spread awareness far and wide. For one thing, I hope you'll share this video message on your social media. This is also a day to thank and celebrate all the many swift lovers who are fighting to protect these magical little birds. And this includes my friend, Martine Wouters. She's known to many as the Swift Lady because she's done so much to share her love of swifts with the world and encourage more people to help conserve them. Happy World Swift Day to all of you. And a special wish and good luck for the swifts. Goodbye.